So let's look at the upsides and downsides of direct math caches. When we access the direct math cache, we need to look in only one place. That makes this cache fast. If we need to look in more than one place, then we need to wait for all of those to be read out. We then need to figure out which one of them, if any, has it, and so on. With a direct math cache, we just check in one place. If it's there, we have it. If it's not there, then it's a miss. So we can very quickly determine whether we have a hit or not. So it's very good for hit time. It is also cheaper than more complex caches because of it. We only need to do one comparison on every access to the cache, so we only need to have one tag comparator, one valid bit checker, and so on. And that also makes it energy efficient. We only need to do one tag comparison and one valid bit check per access, which spends less energy than if we had to check more than one. The downsides of this cache are related to the fact that the block must go in one place. To see why this is a problem, consider what happens if the processor is frequently accessing blocks A and B, like this, where both A and B map to the same place in the cache. When we access A, we will bring it to the cache. When we access B, we need to put it in the same place where A is currently, so A needs to be kicked out. There is no choice about what we kick out, A has to go out. When we access A again, B needs to be kicked out, and so on. So the downside of this cache is that it can have these conflicts, where particular blocks that we want to use fight over the one spot in the cache, although the cache has plenty of other spots that are underutilized. What conflicts do is they increase the miss rate. So we can have a cache that has a fast hit time, but suffers in the miss rate in return.